Hi, I'm Lucy Fry from Vampire Academy Blood Sisters, and I play Lyssa Dragomir. I have a question from Stephanie, and she's asked me, you're an Aussie immersed in the vampire world. Was the transition from Beach Babe to Royal Maroi easy? How did you prepare for the role? Yes, it's a very good question, Stephanie. Well, the transition from being an Aussie beach babe into being a very pale, sun-deprived vampire has certainly been very, very interesting. I started off, when I found out that I got the part, I came back to Australia and started preparing for it there, so it was hard to kind of hide from the sun at that point. But I did, you know, start covering up at the beach with massive umbrellas and sunscreen and trying to hide from the sun as much as I could, which you can now see from how pale I am. But I then started working on the English accent because Lyssa is a royal vampire, and in the process of creating the character, Mark, the director, and I decided that she would be English because of her family heritage. And so that was one of the processes of getting ready to play Lyssa. And then I started doing some acting classes with a Buto coach to kind of figure out the way that Lyssa dealt with the pain of losing her whole family, which is something that I'm not familiar with, thank goodness. So that was a part of getting ready. And then I came to England and I got green eye contacts so that I could have Lyssa's jade green eyes. And that was quite difficult in itself, figuring out how to put contacts in and take them out, and it's very fiddly, and for a while I had just this green world. Everywhere I looked, it was just moldy green, and I was like, why is my world green? But it kind of worked for the part, because Lyssa has trouble connecting with the real world because of all of the things that she's been through and the demons that she has to face from her special powers. So having a blurry world kind of worked for the character for a lot of it. So there was that, and then I had a really great dialect coach here who helped me with the English accent a lot, so that was really, really good. And also, now we're in night shoots, so I stay up all night and I sleep all day, so I am living a vampire life timetable. So I guess the transition from being an Aussie beach babe into being a Maroi vampire princess has kind of, it's felt quite natural because it's been very slow, and I've gradually given up the surfing and given up the sunshine and come into this English world where it's all ancient buildings, and it just feels very vampire, and I feel like I've kind of settled into the role quite naturally, which is really it's a relief. Yeah, it feels like I'm a real vampire now. So thank you for your question, Stephanie.
I don't know about you, but my school can get a little insane. Yeah, we got a situation. Most of us stay up all night, and all of us think that we'll live forever. If we survive graduation, that is.
Thanks.
What are friends for?
Blood is family. Blood is pain. And blood is death.